I bet your company or organization generates and manages vast amounts of data, and the ability to quickly search and retrieve relevant information becomes crucial. For Appsmith users building internal enterprise apps and dashboards, integrating a powerful search engine can unlock a range of benefits and enhance the overall user experience. So today, I'll show you how to integrate Appsmith with Meilisearch to achieve this goal. Meilisearch is an open-source lightning fast search engine with capabilities like full-text search and typo tolerance, filtering, facets, geosearch, ranking, and relevance. Both Meilisearch and Appsmith are open-source and they can be self-hosted, which means you can own both tools on your internal architecture and infrastructure. We'll learn how to achieve this in three simple steps. First, creating a data source that uses Meilisearch REST API. Second, building a search query, and third, create the search UI so you can provide users with the capability of searching and seeing the results immediately. So let's do this. All right, so here I have Meilisearch, which I'm self-hosting on Google Cloud Platform. In case you want to do the same, there is a link in the description which you can read on how to do that. And what I have here is basically indexing content of events. I have a content management system which hosts event information and indexing into Meilisearch. Very basic information like title, description, date, category, topic, and excerpt. And here we have, this is basically the mini dashboard from Meilisearch. So let's go to Appsmith and let's edit our application to start integrating with Meilisearch. First thing we need to do is create a data source, and in this case it's going to be an authenticated API. So let's select that and let's give it a name. I'm going to call it Meilisearch, obviously. And now we need the URL. In my case it's going to be the IP address of my instance, but in your case it could be the URL of your instance as well. And then let's set up the authentication. In this case, Meilisearch uses bearer tokens. And when you set up Meilisearch, you will probably get a master API key. That's the one we're going to be entering here. So let's copy that and let's put it here on the token and let's save that. All right, that's it. Now we can go back to our editor and create our first query. So let's go to the query tabs, create a new query, and select the Meilisearch data source we just created. And as you can see, Appsmith is going to pre-fill the URL, the authentication, and everything for us. Let's just call this search. And what Meilisearch requires is a post request. And the endpoint is going to be indexes slash the name of your index. In our case, the name is event. As you can see here, we are indexing event. So let's go back here and let's call event and then search. That's basically the endpoint we need to call. And now we need to pass the parameter, which is going to be our search term. So let's create an object and let's call it Q. That's the name that Meilisearch expects. And now here we're going to pass our query term. Now I'm just going to pass something hard-coded right now, and then we're going to bind it to a UI. So for now, I'm just going to call, I don't know, I'm going to search for events related to workflows. And since I know that Meilisearch is typo tolerant, I'm just going to fail, obviously. We're gonna call workflows just like that. So now we run it and we should be getting some response, and here it is. Basically it's getting the responses related to workflows, so it's working, it's typo tolerant, and that's the only event related to workflows that we have right now in the content management system. So that's great, it's working perfectly. So now let's build a UI that's going to support this search term. So let's go to the UI and let's bring a input text. This is going to be our search label. So let's call this search. And we're going to change the name here to something like search term. So that way we can reference this field very easily in our query. Let's also bring a text here. So we say that we're going to be showing events. And let's make it large, something like that. And now let's bring our table widget. Sorry, not gonna use a table, I'm gonna use a list to show the response from the API. So let's go to the items, and in this case, I'm gonna be binding this to our query. Remember, we call it search, and then data, and then hits. So as you can see, hits, it's an array. So that's what we need, because the list requires an array as a item data information. As you can see here, we have a sample of the information we're retrieving from the API, which is great. Now let's build our UI in the list. Remember that a list is going to be a repetitive set of fields. So first we're going to be putting the title of the event. Title, there you go. Now here we're going to be putting the description. Great. Let's make this description a little bit smaller, something like this, and a color that is not too black. And the title is going to be maybe L. Yeah, that's fine. L is fine. And color is fine. Now let's bring another element to the list of events. And let's bring a text here for the category or the topic. It's called topic. Topic, there you go. And it's going to be current item dot topic. Here it is. Awesome. And lastly, let's put the date of the event, which is very important. So let's put that here on the right. We're going to be putting it right aligned. And here we're going to be putting the current item dot date. Now, as you can see, the date is not super human friendly. So let's do moment. Remember that Appsmith has moment.js on every app. So let's put our date on the moment.js, and then let's do format. And now let's use the LLL, which is a very simple formatting that moment.js has. Oh, there you go. It's moment, not moment.js. Awesome. So now we have our list of events. It's showing the title, the description, the topic, and the date. We have more information to show, but just for the sake of this testing, we're going to leave it like that. So now what we're going to go is back to the query, and let's replace this with our input text. Remember, we call it search term and call the text property. So that should be good to go. Now let's bind this search input text to the query execution. So let's go to the events here down below and find the unsubmit event. So let's generate a new action, execute a query, and execute the search query. And that's it. On failure, I'm going to show a alert saying that something's wrong. Try again. Something's wrong. Try again. There you go. And I think that should be it. Let's give it a shot. Let's deploy our application. And here we're getting all the results, which makes sense because we're calling the query on page load and we're not passing any search term. So it's going to bring everything, which is great. Now we're pulling everything. Now let's just search for rest. And when we hit enter, the query is going to execute and we're going to get the response back from Meilisearch only with the events related to rest. Also, we can do a API here. There you go. Let me see if I can find another thing that's worth showing. I don't know, topic, which is business. Awesome. That's amazing. Here we have all of the events related to topic business, which is great. So that's it. That's basically it. We just created the data source connected to our Meilisearch instance. We created our query to be able to execute a search, and we bind it to a UI. Awesome. Now, if you want to do something more advanced, like for example, let's say you want to do filtering or geosearch or advanced search, all you have to do is reference Meilisearch API, and you will put all of your different parameters here. One example I can give you, which is very simple, is let's say I just want to bring some attributes from the indexes that we have on the system in Meilisearch. So for example, I want to search by something, but all I want to bring from the response is just the title, just the field title, not everything else. So we can do that. Like if we put something here like API and we go back to our query and we run it, you will see that all we brought from Meilisearch is just the title field, not everything else. So I will say that if you want to do more advanced search, here is probably where you're going to do all of your playground. Reference Meilisearch API docs. We are also putting that in the link in the description, and it's also in the community portal, in the Appsmith community portal. You will see all of the different examples that we have there to use filtering, facets, search, etc. So, but everything is going to happen in this particular field here in the query. And that's it. That's how easy it is to connect Appsmith with Meilisearch to have internal, powerful, lightning fast searches with Meilisearch within your Appsmith app.